The Duchess of Sussex and the Duchess of Cambridge both recycled festive frocks for the Queen's Christmas lunch at Buckingham Palace today. Pregnant Meghan, 37, who is expecting her first child with Prince Harry next spring, opted for a floral dress by royal favorite Dem, which she previously wore in 2016. Meanwhile, her sister-in-law Kate, 36, donned a pretty sure but pink number that many fans believe to be a Stella McCartney creation she first sported in 2011. The royals joined husbands Prince Harry and Prince William for the royal engagement on Wednesday afternoon, their first public outing as a foursome since rumors of a rift first emerged. However, all four appeared in good spirits, smiling broadly as they left the family gathering. Only the smallest glimpse of the Duchess's outfits could be seen through the car windows, but Kate's vibrant candy floss-colored dress certainly stood out. Eagle-eyed royal fans noted the floral and bow at the collar looked strikingly similar to the detailing on the Stella McCartney dress Kate wore for Prince Philip's private 90th birthday party in 2011. The satin frock, reportedly purchased by Kate in March of that year, was the perfect choice for the then-newly minted Duchess of Cambridge as she joined the royals for the meal at 3 Michelin-starred The Waterside Inn, at Bray, Berkshire. The dress originally cost £1,425, but Kate reportedly picked it up for £305, according to a Grazia article as reported by What Kate Wore. While it is possible the Duchess was keeping the dress for a special occasion, today's color does look markedly different from the coral worn 7 years ago. Mail Online has contacted Stella McCartney for comment. Meanwhile, the Duchess of Sussex continued her trend of eschewing maternity clothes and plumped for a dress from her Dem's fall 2015 ready-to-wear collection. The former actress wore the floating knee-length number for an appearance on US program The Today Show in January 2016, What Meghan Wore reported. The outing comes amid continued speculation over the state of relations between the two couples, with a flurry of reports in recent weeks hinting at tension both between Meghan and Kate, and William and Harry. Prince Andrew, 58, Princess Anne, 68, and their father the Duke of Edinburgh, 97, were among the first to arrive for the family gathering today, followed shortly afterwards by the Countess of Wessex, 53, and her daughter Lady Louise Windsor, 15. Princess Beatrice, 30, was also, although her sister Princess Eugenie and brother-in-law Jack Brooksbank have not yet been seen. Peter Phillips, 41, and his wife Autumn, traveled separately, with 6-year-old daughter Isla spotted in the back of his car. Prince George, 5, and Princess Charlotte, 3, were accompanied by their nanny in the back seat of their parents' car, while their grandfather Prince Charles, 70, appeared without his wife the Duchess of Cornwall, who is sick with a heavy cold. A cherished royal tradition, the lunch at the palace provides the monarch with the opportunity to spend time with those relatives who don't join her at the Sandringham estate in Norfolk over the festive season, as well as close members of the family who will be there on the day itself. The Countess of Wessex arrived without her husband Prince Edward in a low-key ensemble of burgundy jacket, chunky knit scarf and a pair of glasses. Her daughter Lady Louise was similarly laid back in a denim shirt. Autumn Phillips, mother of the Queen's great-granddaughters Savannah, 7, and Isla, 6, brought a splash of color to proceedings in a vibrant purple top. She arrived in a separate car to her husband and daughters. The Duchess of Cambridge, elegant in a pink Stella McCartney dress, arrived with Prince William, Prince George, and Princess Charlotte. The Duchess of Sussex plumped for a prettier Dem floral number which she previously wore for a TV appearance in January 2016. Meanwhile, Princess Anne coordinated with husband Vice Admiral Sir Timothy Lawrence in a dark winter coat and bright red scarf. The Princess Royal added a sporty pair of sunglasses to the look. Princess Beatrice wore the same River Island coat she was seen out in last night, and Zara Tyndall showed off her style credentials in a dress by trendy label Mage. Staff have been busy giving Buckingham Palace a festive makeover, with impressive fir trees have erected in the Marble Hall earlier this month. The trees, which were grown in Windsor, were adorned with royal-themed hangings, while a traditional garland decorated with baubles has been put up along the grand staircase. The Queen no doubt has ensured that Buckingham Palace looks the part as she hosts members of the royal family as part of her annual pre-Christmas lunch. The traditional lunch at the palace usually takes place midweek, shortly before the royal family head to Sandringham for the 25th. The annual event provides the monarch with the opportunity to spend time with members of the extended family who will not be joining her at her Norfolk estate, as well as senior royals. The Queen and her family usually wait until the day before Christmas to decorate their tree at Sandringham House in Norfolk, gathering in the White Drawing Room on Christmas Eve to put the finishing touches to a 20-foot tree cut from the estate. This year, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, along with George, Charlotte, and Louis, will be celebrating Christmas this year in Norfolk, despite previous reports that they would be spending the day with the Middletons. It comes amid rumors of a rift between the Cambridges and Sussexes, following the announcement Meghan and Harry will be moving away from Kensington Palace to Frogmore Cottage in Windsor next year.